Thanks very much for having me. As Gavin said, my name is Mortar.
As soon as this gun is fired, if you wish to stay here, you'll be able to see a demonstration put on by the Brunswickers. These are German troops who fought for the English crown during the American Revolution. They'll be coming on right after this mortar demonstration.
I could go like this.
Certainly all day long we're here to answer questions. At 2:30, unless it's delayed a bit, at 2:30 there will be a bit of a battle just up in the area behind us here. The mortar and the gun and the infantry will all be involved in this. Where you're sitting right now is probably a very good place to stay. So that's starting at 2:30, right after the Brunswickers are finished. Very carefully, this cartridge is being put into pouches or kept under coats. This is all designed to prevent any sparks from igniting the cartridge while it's being carried around. The man takes it out from under his coat or out of his pouch. He holds it with both hands so his hands are completely around the charge. He hands it to the other man who's loading now, who also holds it with both hands cupped completely around the charge, again to keep any sparks out of it.
They were not. We've done extensive research in various books and museums in Germany, and the coats were much lighter than, in color than they are portrayed by many other references. 18th century military was much different than it is today. Okay. Of course, it was not the sneak and decent camouflage you have.
Next, he puts the primers,
which was practiced by the troops 4 hours per day. Needless to say, 4 hours a day, he became very, very proficient, much more proficient than we can be doing it on. Short carbine, and the gold braid on his hat and collar is the sergeant.
Okay, that's enough.
Advanced linstock. He's now ready to fire. The linstock, which has been held way back, way away from the powder, is now brought forward. It also is a burning piece of wood. Hold your ears when you see this starting to burn.